we might go do some cooking. So let's listen to the band warm up. I don't even know who it is.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
We tried. They don't take credit cards here.
Cash only.
And they don't have any liquor. So I don't know if it's really my kind of hangout.
They have beer. I just slammed the beer. Can you drink outside? That's kind of a downer.
I don't think so. I think it's illegal. Well, I think you can have a can. You just can't have a bottle.
Oh, okay. Maybe I should have bought a can.
Maybe.
Oh, well, I don't have any cash.
It's okay. A real trendy part of town these days. I think if you walk a little bit further up, they've got all these boutiques that sell shoes for like $300 a pair. Ooh, it's a Chinese witch doctor place.
Oh, look at that.
Get your South by Southwest sass on.
Oh, sass.
Hurry up.
I don't want to have to run.
The light's going to change.
I hate that.
Watch every time. Put it, well, especially if you buy a cheap one. Okay, here's the holy water.
Are you just gonna splash it on me?
I'm just gonna kinda
That feels good.
Breathe that in. We got the candle going here. I'm gonna pull out the bad stuff and throw it out. Throw it out that way. Pulling it out the top of your head.
I'm gonna
throw it out that way.
I feel it. I feel
it. Throw it out that way. Okay, ready?
I think there's still some of it stuck right here.
Okay. I've got a root beer too.
Oh!
The kind in the bottle.
That's what I think I want. I mean, I thought I'd be kind of young and drink a Budweiser, and maybe my body has just said that you've had enough Budweiser.
Here, put
in
the
life.
Healing stone around your neck.
Oh, so. Okay. You're not worried about my
No, root it really is a healing stone.
Okay.
Somebody told me that anyway.
It feels healing.
Well, it is.
I do feel the healing power of Jesus.
Well, of course. He's all over.
He's more in here than he is other places.
Oh, that matches your earrings.
So. Oh, excellent. You know that what was weird was when I felt the best was when the water came and hit me, I think.
Really?
The water was the
Maybe
water.
You were just dehydrated.
Maybe so.
In addition to the lack of circulation mm-hmm. and all that other good stuff.
I think you're right.
I can spray it a little more on you.
That would be good. Okay. And I'll just soak it up through my pores.
There you go. There, that was a real good
That's
dose
good.
Of holy water.
I got
water.
Some on my tongue, too.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and it's combing down your eyes like you're crying. Burp
Excuse
out that
me.
Evil. Burp it,
it
out.
It is evil.
I went to the rodeo on Sunday.
Was it fun?
It was fun. It was a lot of fun.
I
saw Dwight Yoakam. He
I
was
love
real
Dwight
good.
Yoakam.
He wasn't wearing any tight pants though.
He wasn't.
He was wearing some, you know, cowboy suit. Had some kind of stitching on it.
Oh, well, that's nice.
It was a good show. Anyway, yeah, it was real good. The animals were all ornery and stuff. They were fighting and bucking and
they pinched their balls.
Well, there's that, but they were just more active. Are you filming?
Yeah.
Oh, well, hi everybody. Welcome. It's Cooking Good. I'm Arcy Cola. This is Shasta.
Hi everyone.
She's got a bit of vertigo, so she's just having a seat for a minute, but I think she'll be feeling better soon. It is South by Southwest time, and earlier we went to a place on South Congress called Trophies. And we saw a little bit of a band, but it was so loud we couldn't hear each other talk. So then we went and had a hamburger, and then we came here. And now we're going to cook. So I'm going to make a baked chicken. It's springtime. You may have an Easter gathering that you need to go to, or somebody might be popping out a baby soon. It happens. And you need to make something that's kind of substantial to feed, you know, more than three or four people. So we're going to make a baked chicken. And it's real easy to do. The secret is to brine it. And what I mean by brining is I mean soaking the whole chicken in a pot of salted water. And that's the basic idea. And you can put other things. You can put in herbs and spices and sugar, whatever you like. But the main thing is salt. And what that does is it marinates the chicken so that when it cooks, it's nice and juicy, and it also has good flavor. And that's the secret to making a real good baked chicken, even a turkey or any kind of poultry. It's a secret. So I'm gonna show you what to do. First, I'm gonna chop me some vegetables. I like to use squash, yellow and green, with my baked chicken, because they kind of soak up the chicken juices real nice and get nice and buttery in texture.
That sounds good.
So that's what I like to do. And I also chop up, I also like to chop up some onion and garlic just to put in there, give the squash some more flavor, and put some in the carcass of the chicken in the inside. Lordy, so are you feeling any better?
I'm actually feeling worse now after I sat in this chair.
Well, why don't you lay down? Well, okay. You want some water? You want your water?
I
can give you
now.
A straw and you can sip your water.
No, I'm good, right, just like I am.
Well, okay, you can stay there as long as you need to.
Okay.
Say, we're troopers here at Cooking Good. Normally, if it was somebody who was getting paid to do it, they would be at home.
They'd call in sick.
But she's here.
Yeah, and I mean, it's not like I have something that's catching.
It's just vertigo.
Right. I mean,
it happens. It
happens. You know, the ceiling in here is painted light blue, too. I never noticed that. That it goes with everything. That's
Yes. It should be very calm.
It is.
You can just focus on Jesus up there.
Okay.
If you need to. So. What you been up to besides having vertigo?
Well, I hadn't even had any vertigo.
It's new, huh?
Just came upon me when we was in the car.
Well, but, earlier we were fine.
We was fine. Let's see what I...
Well, I just meant in general, your life, what's going on with you right now.
Nothing.
Because we don't really talk to each other very much between shows.
No.
I mean, we do a little bit, and we run into each other at Meemaw's, but... You know, we don't really hang out or anything.
Not a lot, anyway.
Well, no, not a ton. We keep in touch.
Well, not much of anything. I haven't been. I mean, I saw the cult the other night.
Oh, how was that?
It was pretty good. I enjoyed myself.
I didn't know you was into the cult.
Well, you know, I was way back in the day.
Well, but, you know, times change.
Well, yes, and really so has the cult. You know, it really wasn't, I didn't even recognize them. In fact, I really think it might be the cult's children. Just some other guys. Might not even be related.
The cult instead of the cult, huh?
Exactly. But I did get this T-shirt and...
Well, you got something out of the deal, at least.
I wrote some graffiti on the wall.
Oh, well, that's good.
And I had a good time.
Well, as long as you had a good time, I guess it doesn't matter if the band is what you thought it was.
That's right.
I mean, you could go to a concert and just hate the band but have the best time ever. I've done that several times.
Me too.
Musicians, they're so... They're so hit or miss. Sometimes people just don't sound good live.
That's for sure.
I don't know if it's because they don't practice or maybe they're just too drunk or what.
Yeah, or maybe it's not really them singing.
Maybe. Well, that happens. That happens a lot more than you think, I bet.
I bet.
Half the people out there, you don't know what they sound like because they got so many, computer effects on their voices and stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's really too bad.
I can see right up your skirt.
Well, don't look.
I should have got my camera. Well, close my eyes.
I need to get a pan out, but
I'm not looking. Uh-huh. Now my legs in the way. Thank you.
think this is clean. Yeah, it's clean. Sometimes you never know in this house. So what we're gonna do is just put our stuff in here as we get it chopped up, and we'll be putting the chicken in the middle like so. Here's my yellow squash. What's your favorite kind of squash? I mean, yellow and green is pretty much the only kind you're gonna find in the store unless you go to one of them fancy stores. And I find that I like the yellow squash better.
I like purple. The big fat purple.
Well, that's an eggplant, I think.
Well, that's what I like. I like that.
I think it's bitter. I mean, I use it in some things, but if you don't cook it right, it can be bad.
Well, I like it when it's cooked right.
I'm starting a garden this year, because eventually we're all going to have to learn how to grow our own food the way things is going. And I
figure I might
figure out how to do it before the time is dire.
That's what I was going to tell you, is that the earth is stopped wobbling.
On its axis?
Yes, it stopped wobbling. It used
when did
to
this
wobble.
Happen?
Well, I just read about it. It's just really recently, and that's what's going to cause a lot of different problems.
Wow. Well, what's the side effect of its lack of wobble?
Lots of like hurricanes.
Oh, okay.
And the ice caps melting, and also the magnetic poles of the earth may shift.
Oh, really?
Like
switch. Oh, a switch.
And that's gonna cause a lot of problems.
Well, I imagine so. Oh, I forgot. I should probably preheat this oven. I'm gonna put it on like 350 degrees. It's a good temperature.
And I think that's why they're gonna send us to that moon of Saturn.
Is that why they're out there exploring all that stuff?
Yes, because it's like another Earth. And they're just going to send us.
Well, they ain't going to send us, that's for sure.
Well, I mean, I guess they'll send whoever, you know, whoever makes the top, you know, cut off or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I guess we'll have to.
More like the people with the money to build the spaceship, that kind of thing.
Yeah. But that's the plan, I think.
Well, okay.
But,
well, I didn't know anything about that particular plan, but I am growing my own vegetables now. I'm going to start it out. I'm going to grow tomatoes and some peppers, a few different varieties, and some squash, the yellow kind. And what else? I think that's it. Oh, and some herbs.
Well, you have a big enough backyard.
Well, but I'm growing them in pots.
Well, that's good.
But they're the kind of pots
that you
just fill up the reservoir of the water in the bottom, and
yeah.
It just kind of wicks up,
that's
and you
neat.
Can go away for the weekend and not worry about your plants getting all dried out. Wow, that is a strong smelling onion, let me tell you.
Oh, I can't smell it. It hadn't come down here
well,
yet.
Well, it will in a minute. Just give it a second.
I like the smells of onions.
So I'm gonna just chop up some onion here.
Oh, okay, so what I wanna know.
Oh, what?
I've got this whole idea that with this whole thing with the wobble and the earth,
uh-huh.
That we're gonna have like more solar heat storms,
mm-hmm.
and all that up from the sun.
Yeah.
And there's this fella who thinks that it may all be because of the sun.
Oh.
That the sun is causing all this.
How do you know about all this stuff? You never were interested in any kind of astronomy before.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just suddenly sort of become an interest of mine.
Well, do you just look things up on the internet? I mean, because I don't know all this stuff, and I think I'm a fairly well-read person.
Yeah, I just come upon it reading, you know.
Huh. Well, I'll have to start looking more into that.
Yeah, just look it up online. But I was reading about this fella, and he was saying that the sun, you know, has a lot of power that it sends out that, you know, it can really mess us all up.
Yeah.
But I was wondering if it might be because that nobody worships the sun anymore. And maybe,
well, you
maybe
know,
he noticed.
You know, that getting, might be it.
I was going to burn us all up.
I would not be surprised. Let me tell you, I've heard some crazy shit in my life.
I mean, why not? If, you know, if what they say is true and prayer is very powerful.
Well, yes, the sun is probably pissed off.
You don't know. You know, he could at least
been
kind of
taking it for granted for so long,
he
you know.
At least have noticed.
To grow our crops and...
Yeah,
warm
exactly.
Us and all that.
I mean, I'm sure somewhere on there somebody still worships the sun.
Oh, well, yeah.
But I don't know. It's probably just like a tribe in, like, India or something.
It's not enough. Especially because there's so many of us.
No. So, I mean, we might just stop wobbling and, you know, maybe even get all burned up or something.
All right, so I'm just going to chop up some garlic. I'm also just going to put some whole cloves off to the side for the inside of the chicken. Kind of sweat it out on the inside. And then I'm going to pull my chicken out of the fridge. Now, normally on this show, I make it a point to take you through step by step, just like you would if you were to cook it yourself at home. And I've heard some criticism for taking that tack, but I think it's unrealistic when you're watching a cooking show on television and everything's already chopped up and you don't really get a sense of how long it's gonna take you to make it. And so I think we kinda give you a better idea of what's really involved. I mean, you got a lot of time sometimes to do other things. But anyway, I did pre-brine my chicken, but that's only because it takes a couple of hours at least. And I just didn't want to, we didn't have the camera that long today, frankly. We had to get it late, so there you have it. I prepared one little thing. My apologies. But I'm going to pull the brine chicken out, and we're just going to bake this up. It'd be real simple.
Where do you buy your brine at?
You just make it. Now, you can buy a brine that's already pre-made. It's just mixed up dried spices and salt and pepper. That's all it is. So, are you okay?
What's
cameraman.
What's wrong with him?
Oh, he just took a big old swig of whiskey. He's choking over there. He's going to be on the floor with you in a minute.
Just roll on over here, cameraman.
There's room for two people. Good
There's
Lord.
Room for three or four people down here.
Yeah, we could have a great little party now, couldn't we?
We could call it, you know, Vertigo. Vertigo.
Kitchen Vertigo 5000 or
yes.
Something. Something crazy.
Vertigo tonight.
Oh no, you cracked up, cameraman.
It's vertigo. Or vertigo, you know, vertigo. Towers.
I think he hit that whiskey bottle too hard and now he's giggling.
That's not that funny.
That's so funny. No, 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 no. We'd have to make up our own theme. It'd have to be all wobbly and kind of out and distorted.
And
be like,
yes.
It's vertigo tonight.
I can smell onion.
It's garlic I'm chopping up. It's probably the garlic you smell.
That's right.
So anyway, just gonna roughly chop up some garlic and throw in on top of the squash and the onion around the sides. Because they got this laser light show at the very beginning. when they introduced the rodeo.
Oh, no.
And so there's like laser outlines of horses galloping on the sand in like green laser.
No.
It's really cheesy. But that's like, I guess, the new and improved rodeo. And they try to make a big deal out of the bullfight. I mean, not the bullfighting. Well, I guess the bullfighting because of the clowns, but also just bull riding in general. Try to make it into the big event. You have to wait to the very end. But frankly, I think that I enjoy some of the roping events.
Oh, yeah.
And I love the mutton busting, the little kids they have to hang on to the sheep. I'm going to get out the chicken. It's been brining in a pot here in the refrigerator. You don't want to leave it on the counter because that can invite the growth of the nasty things that make you sick. And since there's a bunch of spices in this water, don't just dump it out the sink. You need to strain it all out unless you want to clean out the drain later. So anyway, here we are. Here's our chicken. It's nice and brined. And we're just gonna stuff this onion and garlic here in the body cavity. Just kind of shove it on in there. And then position him there on the thing. And now we're gonna season it up. No, I'm not done yet.
Looks pretty.
It is pretty. Now I'm about ready to season the chicken. And then we're gonna put it in the oven.
Well, it's all that.
That's the brine. That's the stuff that I put it in. And I would show it. It's just water with spices in it. Salted water with spices.
It looks kind of different.
It's had a chicken sitting in it for about 3.5 hours.
So it's gross looking.
Yeah, but that's all it is. You can just mix up any old amount of spices and salt that you like and use that.
What, like cinnamon and?
Well, I guess if you like that on your chicken. I mean, why not? So I'm gonna put on some oil on the chicken and around a little bit on the vegetables. You don't have to do a lot because the chicken's going to get rid of some of its fat too, but that just kind of helps move things along. And just kind of rub the chicken with the oil. There you go. Now I'm going to get me some spices out of the spice cabinet. Think I'm gonna put on some more garlic powder because you can never have enough garlic. And also, what else we got up here? I think I'm gonna put on some cayenne pepper too, and absolutely some salt and some regular pepper. It's just real simple stuff you've got probably lying around in your, just give it a nice jolt of salt there.
What's kosher salt?
Oh, it's just salt that the Jews can eat. I don't know exactly why it's special. I guess you could look it up. I don't know about this song now. This is kind of a strange one.
Sounds like folky to me.
It is folky. It's real folky. Nice bit of cayenne pepper. Give it some oomph. And some regular pepper. And now we're just gonna cover up the whole thing. Are you okay, cameraman?
Yeah.
Okay. We're just gonna cover it up with some foil so that it kind of keeps the juices in. And we'll take the foil off toward the end of the cooking so that it can brown. Okay, and there you have it. And the other thing we need to do is put a pan underneath it, especially if you have just a thing, a casserole dish without a lid like I do. This will help keep your oven clean just in case things start to bubble over, which can happen, and dribble onto your oven. That stuff's real hard to get out. So we'll put this on the cookie sheet. And it's baking at 350 degrees. And we're gonna let it bake at least an hour before we even open up the oven to check on it. And then after an hour, we'll check on it. And if it starts to look like it's about getting done, we'll take the cover off and let it cook for another 30 minutes or so, maybe 40 minutes. Depends on how big your chicken is. And then that's it. It's pretty much done. They just need to understand that they ain't gonna get rid of the colas because we're resilient. We can survive anything.
That's right. We have for millions of years.
It's true. It's true. Colas are survivors.
That's right.
You may be able to pick off one or two, and a couple may pick themselves off through stupidity, but they're gonna breed like rats.
That's right.
This is not all the fan mail that we have received, but we have received more than we thought we would, actually. We're kind of happy about it. It's kind of flattering and strange to know that people are watching our show. And
it's weird.
I mean, I just don't. Anyway, so it's a little weird.
And we didn't know any of them.
No, they just contacted us at the email address, which is colasisters@gmail.com. That's how you can send us an email, and that's how these people did. So anyway, our very first fan letter is from somebody, Kay Becker, and his first email was, "One gay man loves your show. I love you guys, all caps, multiple exclamation points. It is my favorite show. I know you will be famous someday." And that was our very first email, and it made me feel so good, I have to tell you. So thank you, Kay Becker, for being our very first fan letter and being so, so good and nice to us. And I think we will be famous one day. I have a feeling.
Well, I hope so, because I'm just about at the end of my rope. I mean, I don't know what else I'm going to do if I don't win the lottery or become famous and just, you know.
Well, you'll
what
get
else
by.
Is there? You know, I don't know.
Well, here, why don't you read the next one? It starts with the "Hey, good cooking."
Hey, good. That's a long one.
You don't want to read that?
That's a long one.
Well, but I thought you'd like that one.
Okay. Well, I don't think I've. "Hey, good cooking. We ran across y'all at the barbecue festival last year. We were the ones whose dog shit on the festive grounds at the barbecue."
We had that in our show, remember?
And
you were the one who was like, "Your dog's taking a shit."
Yes. That's weird. And they saw the show.
It's
they
a small world.
They must have recognized it. Says, "And y'all filmed it and it aired on your show. At the time, we didn't know who y'all were. But now that we've seen y'all numerous times, we love the show."
They're fans.
"My wife and I were wondering if y'all had any promotional items, t-shirts, stickers, tapes, monthly updates, old tapes, or even a website. We catch your show randomly and would love to know your air schedule."
I guess when we come on. Tuesdays at 11 on Channel 16.
"Appreciate it and send us some promos. Will help get your name out there. Still cooking. Todd and Brooke." They should have said Steele Dutton.
Well, it wasn't them, it was their dog.
Right.
Well, anyway, we don't have any kind of promotional materials. I mean, we're just two girls and some guy that does this on the side. We're not really media savvy. I think, though, we might be getting there the more we kind of go out and see what's going on. And we noticed today that at South by Southwest, people had lots of cards that, you know, you could just leave them out and people can take them with us. So we want to get some of them.
Some cards.
And, you know, maybe
T-shirts.
Yeah, maybe something like that. But we don't really know how to do website stuff. If you can do a website and you want to make one for us, then we'd be happy to give you pictures, you know, whatever. But anyway, so that's our excuse, but we'll get there. Okay, so the next one is from Eddie, and this is what he says. Cola Sisters, I saw one of your shows last night. It must have been shot around Christmas. I don't remember when we shot it, but you made pecan pies and quiche. I've seen bits of your show before and have never just sat through one. You're amazing. Thank you.
Well, that's nice. It's really nice.
I think you've got something there. Two real, in the quotes, women talking the way any other real, in the quotes. I don't know what he means by that, but... any real Southern woman would talk in the kitchen. Now, there's something you don't see on national TV, but should. I agree. Hello. Amen.
I think so.
It's a perfect combination of characters. The smart, very sexy cook. That's me. And the friend who asks questions about the cooking process. I guess that would be you. But she's my sister.
Yeah, I'm not her friend.
I mean, we're not really friends. We're just sisters. You know. Anyway,
maybe we should put that on the show. You know, we're not
friends. We're sisters. If cameraman can put the titles
just
on the show, I don't see why
he
couldn't.
Just run it across the bottom every once in a while.
Oh, here's where it gets a little bit personal with Eddie. I would, however, like to see some more shots of your eyes. I know it's a cooking show, but the few times you looked up into the camera and showed off those beautiful eyes made me want to see more. Your fan, Eddie. Well, Eddie, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. It means a lot to me that you like my eyes. Anyway, moving on. Here's another one.
Oh, okay. Is it the top one?
Mm-hmm.
Your cooking show. Hey, my roommate and I just saw your show for the first time where you two were making mini pecan pies and quiche.
They all saw the same one, I
guess. Loved it. There isn't a ton of great stuff on public access, and your show is definitely one of the few entertaining programs. Are you two still filming? I guess
right
so.
Now.
Also, do you ever have other people on the show?
Yes. We have. We have yes. had other people on.
I know I would love to be on it sometime with you too, if possible.
Sure, yeah. Why not? Count the Jesuses. The winner gets to be
win.
On the show.
Well, great job on a funny, entertaining, while informative program, Shelby.
Thank you.
We've had, a guy, and a lady on mm-hmm. the show so far. Mm-hmm. We've had two people.
Yeah, we have, and we're talking about having more people. And we also were kind of talking about maybe one time doing a live studio thing.
Yeah.
Either we do it here or down at the access station. I'm not quite sure how they rig all that up, but. Anyway, we were talking about it, and if we ever did that, then, of course, we'd want to have people come and be on the show and maybe just sit in the audience, and, of course, you get to sample what we cook.
Yeah, like...
that's part of the deal.
You get to eat it at the end.
Yeah, exactly. So, this is from probably our most, I guess our biggest fan, I should just say it. He writes really long emails. And he really likes watching the show. He's been contacting us after every show and kind of giving us critique. And And we really appreciate that. And he's offered to be the head of our fan club if we ever wanted to start one. So
I didn't know that.
He has. And he also gave us a present.
Oh.
Which, earlier in the shoot when we were down at South by Southwest.
She was wearing it. I wore it.
Well, anyway, I'll read the letter and then you can, you'll find out. Okay, call a sister's fan mail from Jimbo. Dear RC Shasta and cameraman. Okay, so of course Alex Jones used to be my favorite Access TV show. Not anymore. Now it's Cooking Good. Yay!
Dang, that is something.
That is something else.
I think that's like...
I swear, watching y'all makes me... really makes me wish our oven worked. Well, I guess he doesn't have a working oven. I mean, nothing gets between me and the TV set Tuesday nights at 11. I think I've seen 4 or 5 episodes and at least 1 or 2 twice.
Yes, me too.
We do a lot of reruns.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of them.
In fact, I wish you'd play all your shows again so I can tape them. I'm going to try to meet some Asian people to come over and help me with it. I don't know what he means by that, but maybe the Asian people he knows are real good with the taping stuff. Anyway, I just watched the Pies and Quiche. We all got these emails after the Pies and Quiche.
That must have been a good show.
It must have been a show that people really connected to because it's been on a couple times.
The food was so good.
It was.
It was. That was especially good.
It was really. Food. Those little pecan pies were so good.
Were so good. That quiche was good.
Anyway, and felt so sorry for cameraman when his work light fell down and when Shasta knocked the nut crusher off the counter.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I know that must have been embarrassing trying to sweep up every little pecan piece with the camera pointed
That's
at
right.
her. I remember I made you do that. Well, we would have crunched them all over the floor.
We would have.
So, my wife wears clothes a few times, sometimes no times, then sends me to Goodwill with them. And sometimes I see something I really like and pull it out and give it to someone I think might like it. So a couple of weeks ago, she was getting rid of this beautiful bright red Western belt with shiny silver hearts on it, and I thought about y'all. Now, there's only one belt, but y'all can take turns. You seem to get along real well for sisters. That's because we're not friends. We're just sisters. But if you think you might fight, let me know and I won't send it. Or who knows, maybe it won't fit one of you. It didn't fit me at all. Now, I don't know which one, so will you get it if I send it to?
It fits just right. Except, my pants just cut off my circulation earlier, and I think that's what Arcee thought that's what
Well,
made
I thought
me.
That what might have triggered the vertigo was the lack of the circulation.
Lack of circulation. But you can see that I'm not sucking in. Right
yeah,
now.
And it's got
I mean,
room.
Not right now.
Yeah.
You know, so.
So anyway, and he
it's
actually
nice.
Did bring it to
yeah, it's
our
nice.
Mailbox and gave it.
It's real good. Durable.
It's a nice belt. I wish I could wear it, but no, it's way too small. Anyway, that's all for now. Just wanted to let you know that somebody is watching. Oh, and I don't know about Shasta's new boyfriend. I think I'd watch out. Well, you know, that was so long ago. She's had a few since then.
That's right.
Don't want to get mixed up with the wrong crowd. Know what I mean? Wink. Good luck, Jimbo. P.S. When y'all start doing the section of your show where you read Cooking Good fan letters, like this section, it's okay to read any from me that you want to. When you get to the end of the letter where a person signs, you can just say it's from Jimbo. Also, I might can think of some other people who might want to write in. And so we did. We called him Jimbo, and that's not usually his name.
Hello, my sister and I watched y'all's show last night. It was one that we had already seen. That happens a lot.
A lot. It does. It's true.
We just wanted to email y'all and tell you that we watch the show every Tuesday night. It is our date night.
I guess you can have a date with your sister.
We drink beer and watch. We think you guys are so funny and we enjoy the show very much. Keep up the good work. Please email us back if you get this. We would appreciate it very much. Thank you. Raquel and Janae.
We have emailed back all of our fans that have sent us mail.
Yeah, and if I hadn't emailed you back, it's just because I just figured out how to get in there.
Yeah.
And I emailed some people.
Somebody has emailed back everybody. So if you send us mail, we will email you back. And here's the last one that I was going to read. And this actually we got today. I don't even think you've heard about this one.
Right.
It says, I love cooking good. Dearest Cola Sisters, as the subject line to this email states, I love your public access show, Cooking Good. I just discovered your show about a month and a half ago, but it has quickly earned a spot in my Tuesday night TV viewing. I don't think I've loved a public access cooking show as much as I did back in the late 90s when Dominatrix Cooking, I think that was the name of the show, it's been a while, was still on Austin Public Access. That is something else. Dominatrix Cooking. I wish I had thought of that, because I would be doing that, and believe me, if I was doing that, I'd be getting paid to do it. Anyway, but I love your show much, much better than Dominatrix Cooking. You both are so entertaining, and your recipes are pretty good, too. Thank you. Anyway, I just wanted to say that you have a fan in me, and keep up the good work. Your faithful viewer, Mondo. And I won't say your last name. Anyway, thank you for emailing us, everybody.
That is so nice.
I know.
I never expected.
Haven't gotten any hate mail.
I thought we would get some complaints.
But we didn't get any, so I guess we must be doing something right. Anyway, so, if you send us an email, we'll email you back. And our email address is colasisters@gmail.com. And also, I have discovered MySpace, and I have a profile. If you go to www.myspace.com/RCCola, ARCIECOLA, all one word.
Well, oh now it's like, look at cameraman, you look at it too.
Can it
you
get like it? Ringworm.
Is that what they do to you when they take you away
you
in the spaceship?
You need to go get some cream to put on that. I'm going to wash my hands now.
Can you get a good look at this, cameraman?
It's ringworm. You need to stop falling asleep in the gutter.
Now, I think that.
That's so disgusting. I can't believe that's just on your neck.
Is it related to the crop circles?
No, it's not. It's related to you being a filthy person. Are you healed from your vertigo?
No, I still feel the rooms all spinning.
Well, I'm so sorry. We threw the holy water on you and everything, and it didn't work.
And I couldn't remember anything that I was going to tell you.
Well, that's okay. We got time to sit around and wait for the chicken. We got like 45 minutes till we check it.
Yeah, you can't even open it up.
I know. You can say tape, cameraman, if you want to. Okay, so it's been an hour, and our chicken's been cooking with the foil on top. And what I'm gonna do is just take off the foil, and that gives you an idea of what it looks like here. And you can see, I don't want to do that. The squash is starting to get nice and cooked. The chicken's releasing its juices. So we're just going to let it cook a little bit longer. I'm going to get out a knife and a fork. Just kind of test and see how our meat's coming along. Kind of cut here into the breast rib part. See, it looks pretty good. You can't see it well. How about right there?
Yes.
You can see that?
Yes.
So we see that the meat, the juices are running, almost running clear. It's still a little bit pink. Just the tiniest bit pink way down there. It's almost done, and that's what you want to see. So you're going to take the cover off, and then you're going to leave it cooking for another 20, 30 minutes. And what I like to do is turn the heat up a little too. And just keep a close eye on it. You don't want to burn it. But it'll cook up and brown up nice, and the skin will kind of get crispy. So we're going to wait another 30 minutes and come back and see how it goes. That was it.
That's pretty easy. I mean, you know, you just did that brine.
Mm-hmm.
Then you put it in there.
Mm-hmm.
And then you let it sit.
Yeah, that's all you gotta do. It cooks itself, pretty much.
It sure smells good.
It does, I know. It's because it's just about done. Hi. So it's been a few minutes, about 20, and I think it's time that we take our chicken out of the oven. So, here we go. Oh, look how beautiful it is.
Oh, it looks great.
Look at that.
Oh, it's lovely.
Now, it's nice and brown. Our vegetables have browned nicely on the top. There's still a lot of juices down in the bottom. And you can see that the meat juices are clear. And I'm gonna get a meat thermometer just to show you that it's okay to eat. Now when you take this out of the oven, what you wanna do is just kinda leave it. I know I have one of them. Leave it alone for about 15, 20 minutes, kinda let it rest. That lets the juices kinda settle into the meat. And then it retains its flavor. Remember, we brined it so it'd have all that flavor. Well, shit. Hang on, oh, here it is, right in front of my face. Duh. I burned my finger when I did that. So you wanna put this meat thermometer in a thick part of the meat, kind of right back here. And don't touch the bone because the bone's a lot hotter. You just let the mercury rise up and the internal temperature will be the indicator up here. We want to be up here. I'll show you that it's done. We cut into it and the juices are going to run clear. See? And the meat's kind of flaking off there. That's how it ought to look. I guess my meat thermometer's broken, which is too bad, but you don't really need one. Just use your eyeballs. And see, the juices are nice and clear. That's what you want to see. Anyway, that's how you bake a chicken up. And then, you know, you've got your vegetables here on the side. And then you can serve this up with some potatoes or some rice or, you know, whatever side dishes you like. And you can make a bigger chicken. If you make a bigger chicken, just make sure you cook it longer. You can look it up online if you want to, but you know, just use the cut and test, and when the meat's done, it's done. It's that simple. And that's it. I think we're done. So thank you for watching. If you would like to contact us again, our email is colasisters@gmail.com. And Shasta thinks she might be coming down with the bird flu or something. And I hope she's feeling better for the next show that we do. But I'm fine, and we made a chicken. So that's it. Can't believe that's kind of embarrassing that my meat thermometer didn't work. The last time I used it, it worked just fine. Who knows?